Welcome to Storytime, a new weekly YouTube series helping you make the most out of web stories. If you're here, then you're here because you have read or heard about web stories, and that's great. And look, it's easy to jump to the conclusion that these are your standard social app stories, and they just also arrive on the web now, 4 years late. Even the meme about something now having stories is 3 years old. So what gives? Current implementations focus on short lifespans and ultra-low barriers to creation. That means they're less often Pulitzer material and more often humble brags, like me showing off a successful Dalgona coffee or Amazon. Our bet is that the stories format works beyond the ephemeral use case and can become its own pillar in the media landscape. In other words, think of a story as another distinct publishing format on the web, like a blog post, a video or podcast. And we think that they fill a sweet spot between videos and text articles because they're usually cheaper to make than a video and at the same time more engaging than a text article. They're more structured than a video, so you can skip ahead, go back and forth, and so on. And they're as scannable as a text article when done well. But there's more that's different about web stories. They wouldn't deserve the web prefix if they weren't significantly more open than their walled-off social counterparts. Web stories are yours, hosted on your server, making you money and not the serving platform, and can drive traffic to your site, YouTube account, or whatever else you desire. They're also as short-lived or evergreen as you want. And unlike with the social platforms, nobody can dictate what content you create. It's the web, so you make the rules. At Google, we're very confident about web stories to the point where we highlight them in several important places and go the extra mile to let them shine. First, on Google Search, we trigger a visual block like this with web stories on select queries like things to do in New York. Of course, they also regularly appear in the blue links with this nice vertical thumbnail. But our bet is that an even more engaging and natural way is to discover web stories, well, on Discover. Google Discover is the home screen of the iPhone Google app, and it's been growing rapidly. And since web stories are open source and not locked to Google at all, any platform or search engine on the web can build experiences around them. I'm hoping to see many more integrations in the next months and years. Okay, great. This should give you a brief overview, but let's talk a little bit more about this show. This show exists because the way web stories are used is fundamentally new. Besides a handful of publishers, there just aren't that many creators on the web who have a lot of experience with this type of storytelling. Contrary to a blog post, where you start with the written text and then amend it with images and video, it's usually the reverse for web stories. And also unlike a blog post, unless it's highly art-directed, web stories require visual composition, so you might need to level up your design skills a little bit. And hence this series. I want to help you on this journey and share with you everything that could help you achieve success with web storytelling. In the upcoming weeks and months, you'll learn the ins and outs of the editorial process, a lot of design tips and tricks, the publishing workflow and tools, the asset sourcing, monetization advice, and many more intriguing topics. So get going, start creating stories, and subscribe to the channel. And don't hesitate to reach out via the comments below or on the Web Creators Twitter or Google Web Creators Instagram. Onwards.